Trouble for your pride, and I have. haven't got one shred of strength left in me to yeah, knots and bruises, and with my hair done all nice, it's for you, yeah, bloating blue, and with the rats in my shoes, it's for you, yeah, Nord and Shoe, and with the rain on your feet, yes, bitter and sweeter. Bitter and sweet.
'Cause we're all there in lost in this. this is such a pointless cause. Cause we're all very lost, and this is such a pointless cause. Floating through the tunnels of dawn, dampened days in the morning swarm. No body that night to keep me warm.
You're the daughter of Maddie Pryor and Rick Kemp of the British folk rock legend Steel Eyes Band.
That's all true.
Did your parents support your talents when you were a kid?
They did, yeah. They were, when I first said I wanted to become a songwriter, I think they were watching the news or something, and I came downstairs and said, "Mom and Dad, I want to be a songwriter," and they said, "That's very nice, dear," and that was it. But then, you know, when I started making music and they started, they were very helpful, they were very supportive, and even though sometimes they didn't quite know why I was doing it or what I was doing, they were supportive nonetheless, so yeah.
Did you ever have the feeling that the shadow of your parents was maybe like too mighty for you to find your own way?
No, I mean, it's a strange thing. The folk establishment in the UK is a strange thing because they seem to have forgotten the kind of innovation that Steel Ice Band kind of, you know, the genre they more or less created in the 70s. Now they expected me to just sing nice, pretty folk songs and, you know, and I wasn't going to do that. So I wanted them to expect me to be innovative and to do my own thing like my parents did, but they didn't expect that. So I went off and did it anyway.
How would you yourself describe your music?
Well, these days I think it's very influenced by heavy rock, by stoner rock and drone and stuff that me and the band listen to a lot. We listen to a lot of doom and things like that. So I think the sound, especially my guitar sound, I've been working on my guitar sound a lot, and that's very, very heavy rock influence. But my vocals are getting. They change every album, you know. Everything changes every album.
We'll be right back.
And how would you describe yourself as a person?
Sequiny. I always wear sequins on stage. How would I describe myself as a person? Gadzooks, how do you answer that? I would say that I'm a person most fond of sound checks. You know it, and I know it, and he knows it.
At first you didn't play the guitar, actually. You picked it up very late. What made you change your mind?
I did, well, because I'm stubborn. And because people said in the folk world that I wouldn't get anywhere unless I played an instrument. So even though I really like to play the guitar, I did the whole of the first album, arranging most of it just vocally. And I didn't play any instruments on it, I just did the vocals. And then as soon as that was finished, I started playing the guitar. I'm just stubborn. That's what it is. Can I just...
Thank you.
His tan's real. This doesn't come off. That's not makeup. This is real tan. You heard it here first.
Go figure.
It goes lovely with your jacket, though.
Oh, thanks. I love this jacket.
You're very coordinated.
You think so?
You love this guy. He's coordinated.
You're the first to say that,
sequins.
Actually.
No sequins, though. Where are your sequins?
Gone.
Tassels. You need tassels, sequins, and snakeskin boots.
Okay, I'll work on that.
You make sure he does that next time.
Okay, please remind me. What do you think, how much of yourself do your songs express?
Well, 101.1%, I would say.
So all are very personal.
All of it, all of it. It's at some point in every album, there will be every single part of me and what I do. I hope. That's what I hope. And if it's not there, I want people to tell me.
Cut your fingers off.